Here's a wild tour story from the UK. I remember one time we touring overseas, the UK. I mean, this had to be like, it wasn't our first time, but we was pretty new to it. Alchemist was on tour with us. He was DJing and all of that. We was just having fun. So we hopping from place to place, London. And then we got to Manchester. Everything was fine. Everything was cool. And we started performing. And the show wasn't really that long enough because we still was trying to get, you know, our performance together. So we did the show. We got a little bit of love and all of that. And, you know, the show was over. It was cool. We felt like we killed it. But next thing you know, we see this 6'5" tall Indian dude thugged out. Like, yo, man, like the show's not over, man. Like, what the fuck? Like, I want my money back. Like, the show wasn't long enough. I want my money back. So we all looking at each other like, because he had a pass on. Like, he was supposed to be back there, but he's beefing with us. So we like, we looking around like, yo, you know this nigga? Like, who he with? Security is just looking at him. They scared to say something to him. Nigga like 6'5", like, talk about he want his money back. So I at first I thought he was joking, but he was dead ass serious. So we like, what? So we like, we talking to security like, yo, get this nigga out of here. Security looking at us like they don't want to do nothing. So then finally he started saying, he looking at Alchemist. Alchemist had on the chain with some diamonds. So he looking at Alchemist. He's like, yo, man, I want that chain. Or I want my fucking money back. So now we like, wait a minute. This dude's getting too carried away. So eventually the security, you know, they mustered the strength to get the guy out of there. So they ushered him out. We like, all right, that's over. This dude is bugging. So it was time to leave. So we had to go, you know, we walking through the back door. And lo and behold, who the fuck we see? That dude, the dude that's beefing for the money. So he just looking like this. And before we had left out, I seen P grabbing some kind of metal contraption and crumpling it up and making it sharp and doing something. So P was already on point. I didn't think we was going to see the dude when we walked, you know, through the back door to go to the tour van. So we walking out and there goes the dude. And I'm like, damn, it's about to be on. Yo, P just grabbed that little metal contraption thing that he had, whatever it was. As soon as he walked past that dude, boom, hit him in the face with it. Yo, his whole face was bloody. His whole face was bloody. So we was just like, we ran into the van. We got into the van. We was like, hurry up, close the door. We like, driver, drive. So the driver driving, he got to bust a U-turn. Then the dude is in the middle of the street like he about to pull out and start busting at the van. And we just got the fuck out of there. We was out. And that shit was crazy. Word. Dude wanted his money back. He wasn't getting his money back, but he got something. So, you know, we would go back to the UK, of course, and one of the destinations would always have to be Manchester, because, you know, that's where we get love at and all of that. And that always used to be in the back of my mind, like, if we do this show, will this dude pop back up again? But we've been to Manchester several times, and I never seen him since, ever. And, you know, that kind of surprised me. But P held it down, you know, for who P was and the size he was versus that dude. Hands down, that dude P was a brave motherfucker, yo, because he just took matters into his own hands. He bust that dude in the face with some kind of metal thing, and he got us up out of there, yo. P had a lot of heart, and that's my dude for life, yo. R.I.P. Prodigy, for real. I saw it with my own eyes, P holding it down.